me to tell you the story of the curse of the Colonel, but to tell this story, we will need to travel a world away. Let me take you over to Japan. Some of you have heard of it, some of you likely haven't. There is a mysterious link between Colonel Harland Sanders, founder of Kentucky Fried Chicken, and the Hanshin Tigers Baseball Club. The Tigers won the championship, the Central League pennants in 62 and in 64, but since then fell behind their rivals, the Yomiuri Giants, who peeled off 9 championships back to back. And they became a bit of a losing team until 1985, had a magical season, and with a few games left, only needing a tie or a win against the Swallows, the team rallied from behind, tied the score, and then were able to finally win for the first time in 21 years. Fans went bananas. Everyone was loving life. Every fan in the Kansai area, hundreds of miles away from their heroes who were playing afar in a field, could not help themselves. They were going outside and singing and dancing and having a blast. Some of them gathered outside the Dotonbori Canal and they began to sing a particular song. Each of the players had like a coming onto the field song. They sung the songs one by one according to the Hanshin Tigers batting order. Now, for reasons that will be lost to time, a ritual started by the canal to celebrate the victory. A fan resembling each player would jump into the river, and basically each fan looked like a player. So let's just say there was a fan named Kenji, and he looked a lot like Tony, right? And so Kenji's like, "I'm Tony, we're number one," and he'd jump in. And then another fan who looked like the player Mayumi would jump into the river to celebrate. And then another fan who looked like Hirota would jump in. And every fan would basically take the role as an effigy of one of the players and jump into the water to celebrate. The Japanese fans had a particular problem, though. One of the players was an American. His name was Randy Bass. And Randy Bass did not have any fan that looked like him because he was an American. You know, this is a Japanese town. And since they couldn't find anyone that looked like Randy Bass, and this is in 1985, since they couldn't find anyone that looked like Randy, they decided to go storming around till they found someone. And they looked over and saw a Kentucky Fried Chicken restaurant with a smiling statue of Colonel Sanders outside. This is a thing. I don't know what it is, but KFC is very, very popular in Japan, to the point where if you're here in the States, what is a special food that you pick up from a restaurant for either Thanksgiving or Christmas? It has a whole store. It comes in the gold wrapping paper. You all know what I'm talking about. What's a particular food here that's like a holiday food that you pick up here in the States? Or at least the States. I know maybe even Canada. It has the gold wrapping paper. It's a honey baked ham. Exactly. For those of you who don't know, here in the States at least, either Thanksgiving or Christmas, it's interchangeable. If you're lazy, you'll go pick up a honey baked ham. It's a big fucking ham. It's covered in gold paper. It's got ham crusted on the side of it, and you serve it and it's a success. No one has to cook. You can eat that bitch cold and it shows up. It's delicious. Well, in Japan, there's a whole holiday tradition of eating KFC. Don't believe me? Look it up. KFC Christmas in Japan. It's a whole thing. They, as part of their branding, they have these statues of the Colonel that sit outside the restaurants. Well, Randy not only is an American and the Colonel's American, he also happens to look like the Colonel to a degree. Like, Randy Bass kind of has the same mustache as the Colonel. So the mob picks up the statue of Colonel Sanders and they're like, The store is like, "Please don't take the Colonel. Please don't take him." But the drunken hooligans are getting rowdy and they kidnap the Colonel Sanders statue and they're hoisting him in the air and they're singing. Finally, they get him to the river. They sing Randy Bass's song and they throw the Colonel Sanders statue into the river. It sunk into the murky waters and a curse was born. Ever since they threw the Colonel into the river, and these are just a few of the events, and I quote, "Star slugger Masayuki Kakifu got beamed on April the 20th, 1986, ending a 663-game Iron Man streak. A month later, he returned for 11 days before injuring his shoulder while in the field. He suffered a third injury that August, breaking another bone. He had to retire from the 1988 season only at the age of 33. Ace pitcher Chikafusa Akita broke his heel bone while recovering first base. The team finished the 1987 series with its worst winning percentage ever. Randy Bass was dismissed in the middle of the 88 season when his son got exceedingly ill and he had to stay home to take care of him. The team lost out on 12 consecutive first-round draft pick lotteries, and the team didn't win another pennant until 2003 and have still not won the Japan series since then. The Colonel was at the bottom of the river, and the team was cursed. Now, here's the thing. A lot of these curses are invented in the eyes of the media. For the first two seasons after the incident, no one spoke about the curse. Everyone was just confused that a very strong team like the Hanshin Tigers could become so weak so quickly. But then a late night TV show called Night Scoop, Night Scoop, which had viewers send in questions or requests for their team to investigate. In March 1988, they got word that the Colonel Sanders statue should be recovered to break the Hanshin Tigers curse. So the host of the show tried to find the Colonel. They were the very first ones in the media to perpetuate the idea of a curse. And I quote, "Until the Colonel is rescued and cleansed of the sludge, Hanshin has no hopes of winning a championship." The curse was born. They looked for the statue, but couldn't find it. And the years went by, and the team embarrassed itself more and more, and all of the credibility disappeared. Ever since then, attempts were made to find Colonel Sanders. They sent divers down. They dredged the rivers and couldn't find any hide nor hair of the Colonel. Fans apologized to the KFC store manager, but the statue remained in the canal, and the Tigers were still cursed. Leaping into the Dotonbori Canal, and the curse of the Colonel was only associated with the Hanshin Tigers' victory when Japan itself, and I think the Tigers in Japan, beat Tunisia in the World Cup. 500 fans dove into the canal as a celebration. In addition, another Colonel Sanders statue, when they beat Tunisia, was taken from a storefront and its hands were cut off. That's a mockery of I guess, Sharia law. I'm not sure in what poor taste it was done, but that's they kidnapped another statue and cut its hands off. In 2003, the Tigers had a strong season but lost the Japan series. The curse remained intact. Fans kept diving in trying to find the statue to no avail. After losing the Japan series that same year, fans dove in. 5,300 fans plunged into the canal, and most KFC outlets began chaining their colonels down. After this rash of colonel kidnappings, most KFC outlets in Kobe, Osaka, and other towns began to chain or bolt their colonels from the rabid Tigers fans. The one in the original branch, they had to have it bolted down several times to avoid a repeat of the incident. And it wasn't all fun and games. In 2003, that big celebration I was telling you about where the 5,300 people dove in, 24-year-old fan Masaya Shidibaba, he actually drowned in the canal amidst all of the commotion. So people are starting to die now. People are starting to get injured, and there's more and more colonels getting taken. They had to build a whole new bridge in 2004 to make it more difficult to do this should the Tigers ever win again. But flashing forward now to March the 10th, 2009. During the annual routine cleaning of the canal, around 4 p.m., Osaka City workers discovered something. It was the Colonel. First, his upper body was found. They thought it was a dead body. They were like, "Oh God, we've got a body over here. It's the Colonel. The Colonel is back." They continued their search, and they were able to find his right hand. A short time later, they were able to find his lower half, and for the first time in 24 years, Colonel Sanders was able to stand again. Relief swept over the entirety of the Tigers fan base. Let's go, boys. We're gonna win in 2009. There was a catch, though. They would only finish fourth in the Central. No Japan Series championship still. Why? They found the statue, right? They found the Colonel. He's been rescued. Why won't the curse end? What's going on? Why won't the Tigers get the Japan championship again? His left hand is still missing, and his glasses too. It is said the only way to lift the curse is by reuniting the Colonel with his long-lost glasses and his left hand. He is still incomplete. even though they took him and they ceremonially cleansed him in the at a shrine, they completely cleansed him down. They had him on display at the original KFC. Then they took him to KFC headquarters and put him in a vault. Then they had him displayed at another restaurant. They're still looking for a championship, and they're still looking for the hand, and still looking for the glasses. They are lost to this day, and as such, the Tigers continue to lose to this day as well. The curse continues. I just want to show a quick video of them dredging the Colonel out of the water because it's really good.
さてこちらケンタッキーフライドチキンのカーネル・サンダース人形です。24年前阪神ファンによって道頓堀川に投げ入れられ行方不明になり、以降タイガースの低迷はこの呪いだとまで言われてきました。昨日救出されましたこの人形、果たして呪いは解けるのでしょうか。
8時53分、ライバーが潜ってからおよそ3分で右手が発見されました。
下半身ですね。
大阪道頓堀川では今日もあの男の救出劇が展開された。そう、あの男とは四半世紀の時を超え、昨日奇跡の生還を果たしたケンタッキーフライドチキンのシンボル、カーネル・サンダースだ。今日も彼の体の一部が次々と見つかったのだ。遡ること24年前。
He's back, baby. The Colonel is back. Thank God. Marisa Sachs talking about the curse of the Colonel. He was dumped in the canal as a victory celebration, and the Hanshin Tigers never won after that. But he is still missing, to this day, his left hand and his glasses. So if they ever find it, maybe one day, they will finally be able to eke out a victory. But until that day, the curse of the Colonel remains. So if you're visiting and want to bring your diving gear, well, you too could end the curse of the Colonel.